Hey there everybody, how you doing? It's me, your boy. Welcome to Caves and Cliffs Big Hype Week number 3. Yep, that's right, another week, more cave update news confirmed for you. If you caught week 1 or maybe week number 2, you already know how this goes. In this video, we'll be talking about new or freshly confirmed Caves and Cliffs update information. There's also a few other things that I'd like to talk about today. We'll talk about those a little closer to the end of the video though. So gamers, make yourself seen. If you enjoy this series, if you want it to keep coming, leave a like on this video, and if you haven't subscribed yet, definitely change that today. Also, drop a follow on my Twitter. Okay, that's enough. Let's go. This week we start yet again with basically the creator of the series, King B-Dogs. King B-Dogs put out a tweet about SCULK sensors, and oh boy, it caused quite a stir. And to be clear, by stir, I mean information. This week we have a lot of new SCULK sensor information. I actually wasn't even going to make this video this week, I was going to skip it because honestly, there just wasn't too much, but after this tweet, everything changed. So anyways, you've probably already read it, but the tweet reads, "There's a mod going around that adds SCULK sensors." We checked that one out, card on screen right now. "This is super awesome. Just keep in mind that it is a mod, and it won't necessarily work the same way as the real blocks. One example, SCULK sensors do not react to sound, they react to vibrations. Not all sound equal vibration." Interesting. King B-Dogs, could you explain? The king never lets us down. In a separate tweet, we got this. "Vibrations might be the wrong language for SCULK sensors. We are still figuring out what we define it as, and perhaps we'll need to work together as a community to figure that out. However, our core principle so far is, if it makes noticeable physical motion, it is a vibration." So admittedly, this is definitely a tiny bit confusing because, I mean, if you think about it, a sound, any sound is technically a vibration. But thankfully, if we dig through the replies on these two tweets, we can get a lot more information and kind of start to understand what the devs are thinking with the SCULK sensor and vibrations. We'll start with a clarification of the word vibrations in the context of Minecraft. In Minecraft, not all sounds are actually considered vibrations. That's where things get a little bit more confusing. Okay, let's take a look at some things that are vibrations and some things that aren't vibrations. Eating, will it detect when you eat? Yes. Eating? That's definitely a vibration. If a piston is pushed or a piston pushes a mob, will that activate SCULK sensors? Yes. Piston movement and mob movement, definitely a vibration. Mr. PD Wash coming in here with the big question. Am I right in assuming the placement of blocks is not considered a vibration of the sensors, since that would cause unwanted redstone signals? King B-Dogs with a reply. At the moment, placement is considered a vibration. It's valid point though that it could get annoying when building contraptions. So it seems like, just like in the mod that I checked out, yeah, you're gonna wanna place your SCULK sensor down last, for sure, because block placement is a vibration. What about things like drinking a potion or putting a shield up? Those are technically movements. Yes, good point, good point. King B-Dogs, I think the plan is for those to be detectable by SCULK sensors. So potion drinking, shield putting up, vibrations. Okay, but how about flying? People using elytra, the sound is pretty quiet after all. What do we think? It will likely detect flying players because in my head, the air getting pushed aside next to the player is noticeable to the SCULK sensors. I definitely second that, 100%. If they can detect a player walking, they better be able to detect a player flying. Okay, so eating, pistons, mobs moving, placing blocks, things like raising a shield, drinking a potion, flying, those are all detections. What isn't? Well, here we have this. Currently, mobs making their idle sounds, etc., don't cause a vibration. While a sound is a vibration, to the SCULK sensors, it's not causing significant physical motion. So it can't really see a mob making noise that way. So let's go back to that SCULK sensor video. If you saw it, near the end, we built a machine that fed a cat every time the cat meowed. That meow is an idle sound, so the SCULK sensor won't be able to detect that kind of sound. A sound that just sort of happens from a mob. Think maybe that Enderman sound or a zombie growl. Those sounds are idle sounds, which are sounds that won't be able to be detected by the SCULK sensors. But why not those sounds? Well, it probably comes down to two big things. Thing number one, performance. I mean, think about it. If you have a SCULK sensor down detecting every single idle sound, including things like cave sounds, that would be crazy. Cave sounds have also been confirmed by King B-Dogs to not be detectable by SCULK sensors. Thing number two, there's a lot of idle sounds in Minecraft. The direct context of King B-Dog's tweet on idle sounds was about mobs, but think about it. Is that nether portal sound an idle sound? What about the lava sound? Yeah, those could definitely maybe be considered idle sounds as well. And if they are, yeah, there are just so many idle sounds in Minecraft. The skulk sensors would basically become pointless because they would be overloaded with sounds. So lots of confirmation as to what the skulk sensor can detect, and some clarity as to what skulk sensors won't be able to detect. Unfortunately, gamers, this means no automatic cat feeder. Okay, so that's the skulk sensor, but how about the warden? The warden and the skulk sensor are pretty similar after all. How will the warden detect sounds? Will it be identical? Will it be different? Well, it sounds like it will actually be identical to the skulk sensor. So if you can understand one, then you understand both of them, because they're made from the same stuff. That's really interesting. To be fair, it's something that we already kind of knew based off of the appearance of the warden and the skulk sensor, but definitely interesting. So this does indeed mean that the warden will attack any mob that makes a vibration, not just the player. It seems like the warden is basically going to be the new Zoglin. That's gonna be crazy. But remember, the warden also takes out like half of your health in netherite, so forget about the Zoglin. It's not even relevant. The warden is literally going to be a nightmare for everything in Minecraft. Other than other wardens. King B-Dogs did also confirm that wardens won't fight wardens. One final thing on the skulk sensors, then we're going to move on to something entirely different. Will the skulk sensors be craftable, or will they only be naturally generated? Skulk sensors will be naturally generated, but there will be ways to get it through renewable means. So we know literally nothing about this, but does that mean, maybe, if I want to theorize a little bit here, do wardens drop skulk sensors? That would be renewable. Wardens keep spawning. I don't know. Don't get me wrong. Definitely no confirmation on that one. That was speculation, but definitely very, very interesting. Okay, let's move on to some other things. Barvax had a question for Ulraf. The ceramic pottery is cool. Would you consider doing glazed tiles too? Ulraf replies with apparently one of Ulraf's favorite memes. Mayhaps. What does it mean? I'm not too sure, but I felt like I would show you guys. Archaeosystems will be implemented in the Nether too? Because there are ancient debris and ruined portal. I mean, that's treasure for all archaeologists. And I think that the story of Minecraft is not all about the overworld. Ulraf replies with, wait for it again. Mayhaps. Again, not a confirmation, but definitely interesting. Side note, Ulraf just made a YouTube channel, a card on screen right now. Slide over there, elites. Give Ulraf a big warm elite hello, and check out Ulraf's VOD. This past week, there was a live stream with Echo Soldier, Cubfin, Etho, and Izumavoid, as well as Ulraf. They talked all about the features of Minecraft Live. The VOD is on Ulraf's channel. Remember the Mesh Caves, a biome that was briefly teased a couple weeks ago? Well, here's the inspiration for the Mesh Caves from Henrik, another Minecraft developer. That looks crazy! I don't even know what that is, but it looks cramped. One thing though, considering the fact that Bedrock players can't crawl still, the caves must be at least a little bit bigger. That, or Bedrock Edition is finally going to get the ability to crawl. I've seen this image going around a little bit this past week, and I've got some questions about it. Minecraft 1.17 is not confirmed to have a new flower or anything like that. Henrik was just working on something and needed a placeholder texture. So that's what that yellow and red thing is. And finally, today we'll end off with this beautiful image from KojoMax99. Check this out. That is, in fact, growing amethyst. The two amethysts that we can see in this picture are amethysts that we actually haven't seen quite yet. Now, the first one, the one on the left, definitely looks like it's the start of a growth. Then we have maybe the middle stage, and I would guess that the final one, the one that we saw back at Minecraft Live, is maybe the final fully grown stage. Three stages, it seems like it would make sense. And I mean, based off of what we see here, if these are the other two stages, three stages would 100% make sense. But look at this stuff. It looks like amethyst will grow on that purple block, something that we kind of already knew, but wow. Look at it, growing amethyst. That is so sweet. That is really, really cool, and oh boy. Excited for Amethyst, for sure. I can't wait to see what else they do. Hopefully they do more than just craft the telescope. So, for Caves and Cliffs news, that is actually just about it for today's video. Now I'd like to talk about Minecraft 1.16.4 real quick. According to the 1.16.4 pre-release 2 blog post, 1.16.4 should drop sometime this week. And then, after 1.16.4, I think, the plan is 1.17 snapshots. Still no official confirmed date for 1.17 snapshots, but gamers, hopefully soon. Hopefully. And finally, back over to the Minecraft website for this blog post. This is the blog post on capes. I actually made an entire video about this stuff. If you haven't seen the video quite yet, there's a card on screen right now. One thing that I brushed over though when making that video, this bit right here. Read this. This way, everyone will know that you were there for the big move and that you might have an impeccable sense of fashion, talking about the capes. And who knows, you might even have more than one outfit to show off. But we'll tell you more about that later down the road. So this could definitely mean a couple things. Thing number one, how I see it, more than one cape. More capes coming in the future. Something that we definitely talked about in the video. The other thing that this could mean could have to do with the character creator, because I mean, think about it. The character creator is all about creating different outfits. Maybe I want Minecraft Alex to, I don't know, have the blue jeans that Steve has. Yep, definitely changing the outfit here, 100%. So maybe here, this is a tiny hint that the character creator may be making his way to Java Edition, which would be really weird. But it also would be kind of cool. Now remember that it was already confirmed that the players will still be able to use their custom skins after the account migration happens. So custom skins aren't going away, but maybe the character creator is making its way over to Java Edition. Remember though, not confirmed. It's just speculation on that bit right there. Definitely not confirmed. Not at all. And so for Caves and Cliffs Big Hype week number 3, that is actually going to cut it. What do you think? Today, take your best guess down in the comments below. When do you think 1.17 snapshots will begin dropping? Let me know about that down there. While you're heading down there, make a quick stop at the like button and the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed yet. Remember that notification bell too, elites. If you tagged me in any of the stuff that I talked about this week over on Twitter, big thank you, it helps a lot. If you want to help make next week's episode of this series, continue tagging me on stuff on Twitter, share it over on my subreddit r/waddles, and until next time, stay fresh gamers, I'll see you in the next video tomorrow. Goodbye.